The Mana electorate office has been the place of last resort for many constituents. It has often been said that all politics are local. The people of Mana have grounded me. Their realities have informed my work in Parliament. Mr Speaker, in October 2007, the Porirua City Council Pawatahanui Burial Ground Bill, which I sponsored, was passed into law. It was a simple piece of legislation that dealt with management issues relating to the Pawatahanui Burial Ground and ensuring it is looked after in perpetuity. The bill had the support of the local iwi, Ngāti Toa, the Stace family who had gifted the land, and the Pawatahanui citizens who have cared for the many heritage roses on the grounds, which date back over 150 years, when the first cuttings were brought there by early settlers. Sometimes a small success can be quite profound. It is very satisfying to walk amongst the roses in a graveyard on a summer's day in Pawatahanui and know that this Parliament gave unanimous support to protect that historic site forever. We have had many other successes in Mana over the last few years. The rebuild of Porirua College, the Porirua Housing Renewal Scheme, the Kapiti Health Centre, 24 hours A&M services at Kenepuru Hospital, the purchase of Wharerua and Waitangirua farms for the conservation estate, Mackay's Crossing Overbridge, the median barrier strip on Centennial Highway, progress on the transmission gully route, improved early childhood education services, particularly for Pacific children, business growth and reduced unemployment. Sadly, the tide has turned and we are seeing some of the gains of the last decade fading. But surely the tide will turn again. Mr. Speaker, over the last few days and weeks, I have been quietly ticking tasks off my to-do list as I exit Parliament. A big tick was the selection of a Labour candidate to replace me in Mana. Chris Faafoi won a very hard contest from four quality candidates for the forthcoming by-election. Chris is a young man with much to offer the people of Mana. I wish you good luck, Chris. As I leave Parliament, I will not be looking back. I did my best for more than a decade. Now it is the time to move on. My new role of Assistant Vice-Chancellor Pacifica at Victoria University is an exciting opportunity to promote Victoria as the university of choice for Pacific students and staff in New Zealand and the Pacific region. I am very excited and looking forward to starting work at Victoria University in November. Mr. Speaker, during my time in Parliament, I have made many friends and worked with many wonderful people on all sides of the House. My colleagues' support for me and all of you during the good times and the difficult times has been a great source of comfort and encouragement, and I thank you all from the bottom of my heart. I want to acknowledge with love and thanks the unseen workers of Parliament, the staff of the Clerk's Office and Speaker's Offices, Parliamentary Services, caterers, cooks, cleaners, ushers, security, the VIP drivers, the report writers, Hansard staff, all those who work in Parliament. A special thank you to my loyal parliamentary and electorate staff, Tau Ili Ili Nari, Shane, John, Debs, Edward, Moana, and also Filippo, Jeremy, and my former ministerial staff. You have all served me wonderfully well. To Phil Goff, Annette King, and Andrew Little, the leaders and president of the New Zealand Labour Party, thank you so much for your support. Thank you to my colleagues in the Labour caucus. A special thanks to my little brother Darren for looking after me and negotiating this time for me to say goodbye. Warm thanks to the Mana LEC and all the Labour Party members, union affiliates and supporters for your loyalty and hard work. I have kept my family out of the public gaze and political arena, apart from my brother Ken, who can be seen regularly on Sky Sports. My greatest support has come from my family, to the family in Samoa and New Zealand. Finally, the love of my life, my husband Peter, the Cantabrian. Alofatu. Peter has chosen the song to conclude my speech, Le Manutangie, a Samoan farewell and lament. It was composed by my uncle Siaki Laban and will be sung by my niece, Marlena DeVoe. Whaftei te le lava malo alofa, malo angalelei, toi stofa soifua.